Welcome to this El Nino briefing. My name is Mark O'Malley with the National Weather Service next. El Nino is defined by abnormally warm water across the equatorial Pacific Ocean that couples with the atmosphere to create changes in the overall circulation pattern and in turn weather patterns. Specifically, we look at sea surface temperature anomalies near the equator in the East Central Pacific. In this key Niño 3.4 region, we need unusually warm water of at least 0.5 degrees Celsius above normal to persist for several consecutive months in order to effectively change the weather patterns downstream directed towards the United States. In these images and animations, we can see warm water has been prevalent for several months, but not until recently has extensive very warm water covered the entire Niño regions. Much of what happens at the surface of the ocean can be traced to events occurring several hundred meters below the surface. Organized deep ocean waves move large amounts of water west to east, as well as from the open ocean depths to the surface and vice versa. These processes have helped cause warming of the equatorial Pacific waters since this past spring. However, large fluctuations during the past 7 months. Because of this, we've only been flirting with El Nino conditions and the necessary ocean atmospheric linkage has not yet fully materialized. In forecasting El Nino conditions, we look at numerous dynamic and statistical models keen on the sea surface temperature anomalies in our vital Niño 3.4 region. By utilizing many model solutions, we can visualize the spread and average of all the models to get a sense of the possible outcomes and most likely outcomes. From all these models in this image, we can see the most likely outcome, or average of the models, yields a sea surface temperature just above 0.5, the El Niño threshold, for several months heading into the spring of 2015. A few models never fully reach the El Niño threshold, while an even lesser amount push sea surface temperature anomalies into the moderate category. Another way to quantify the spread uncertainty in forecasting El Niño is by using probabilities of occurrence. In this graph, we see almost a 60% chance of El Niño becoming established through the winter season, with declining probabilities thereafter. Neutral ENSO conditions in the green bar are the most likely outcome by the end of spring 2015, with almost no chance of La Niña conditions ever developing. So what does a weak El Niño mean for Arizona? Unfortunately, we can't determine too much. These graphs show the spread in winter precipitation during El Niño, La Niña, and neutral phases for different climate divisions within the state of Arizona. While El Niño winters generally provide better chances for above-average precipitation, there remains a large spread in potential outcome. In fact, there are some El Niño winter seasons that lead to below-average precipitations, and while not shown here, these tend to be the weaker El Niño events. So in summary, there is nearly a 60% chance of El Niño becoming established this winter and lasting until the spring of 2015. The most likely outcome is only for a weak El Niño event, which has very limited predictable influence on weather in Southeast California and Arizona. Thank you for viewing this multimedia briefing. You may also find us on the web, on Facebook, and Twitter at the address listed here.